Okay, so these are some of the dresses that have inspired today's episode. I'm doing a pattern review on McCall's 7742. You guys, I'm so excited to be doing this pattern review. I have been, I've had the dress made, but I've been kind of keeping it a secret. I'm gonna go get it and I'm gonna just go through all the details and just tell you why I love this dress. Okay, this dress is so easy to make. I don't know why it doesn't say on there easy, but this dress is great for beginners. I made it with a rayon challis fabric. I'll read to you the description. It says that it is a very loose fitting dress. It has a front and back yokes and gathers and sleeve variations. There's no enclosures that you need to add on it. You don't need to add interfacing either because the top is fully lined and it's just, let's see, would it be? Yeah, three pieces. Well, okay, but you do line it. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I will go and try it on, but the top is fully lined. And so that is how you do that. I love the V-neck. So here it is. It's lined. I just lined it with a cotton that I had. It's actually a sheet, but see, and then I love that V-neck right there. And then it comes short. You don't have to add a separate sleeve. See, the sleeve just kind of curves down like that. I didn't add the ruffles or the cuff because you can add that separately. See, that one has where you can add a cuff. That one has where you can add the ruffle sleeves. And just to make it a quick sew, I didn't do that. Also because I added, this part is ruffly, and then I added a tiered ruffle at the bottom. So you can see, I love the drape of it. This is a, I think I mentioned it, a rayon challis fabric that I got from fabric.com. Okay, and then I will tell you the measurement details. It comes in an extra small to an extra large. And see, this is, so if you want the smaller size, you have to grab another envelope. This one is large and extra large. And the bust size range, you know, from an extra small to an extra large is, it goes from 29.5 all the way up, I'm sorry, it goes from, yeah, 29.5 all the way to 44 inches on your bust size. So my bust is a 40, so I used a large and it was still pretty big. I could have gone down to a medium, but because of the bagginess, you don't have any enclosures on it. It does come with pockets as well. This one says that you can cut out an interfacing. I just lined it with the cotton fabric. Not a lot of details to share on it. I'm gonna turn it inside out so you can see what it looks like. It's just really clean on the inside because it's fully lined. And then I just folded this over because I didn't add a cuff or ruffles. I just folded it over and sewed it. And so I already had serged the edges. And then this is what it looks like on this side. Okay, so this is the neckline. This is what I always do. Now I'm going to take my pinking shears and I am just going to cut off the excess amount. And then when you do V-necks, you kind of have to cut deep in there. And so I am just going to take my fray check and put that on the raw edges. This is a rayon challis fabric, so I like to put fray check in those little areas because, you know, it is kind of tricky to sew with the rayon challis, but I love the drape at the end when I get the dress all finished, and it's nice and flowy and summery and lightweight for the summertime. And the reason why I'm not serging around the neck area is because I am going to turn it inside out and I'm also going to top stitch it. So I just didn't want all the extra thread bulk. And when you use pinking shears, it lays nicely around the curves. So, okay, all of that looks really nice. So now I'm just going to turn it inside out. Or, you know, just flip it around. And if that V-neck is not laying well, then I'm just gonna go in and I'm gonna clip it again. Because, yeah, I'm not sure how that's gonna turn out, but let's see. So I'm laying this out, and see, because I clipped the curves on the inside, the roundness is just looking really neat. There's no puckering or creasing, and so I'm just trying to let it lay naturally, and then I'm gonna work on the V-neck. And you know, I do always get nervous when I'm working on the V, because right now it does not look very well, but I am gonna tinker with it a little bit. So let's see here. I'm gonna iron this part down. And you guys, I forgot to stay stitch the bodice. I always forget to do that. Okay, I don't have the V figured out yet, but I'm just gonna clip around all the other edges and get those, that fabric to lay nicely in place. And then I'll mess with this at the very end. This rayon is kind of flexible, so I'm just gonna maneuver it into a V. So yeah, it's not gonna be perfect. I almost wonder if I can just go like that. Okay, so with the way that the pattern is, I just kind of overlapped that a little bit. And I'm just gonna sew it down into a beautiful V, and that should work. Here's the thing, guys, I never thought I would care what my V looked like. So just a very simple dress. I'm gonna be making a lot more of these ones. That there are some more inspirations. I have red fabric already available that I'm going to make a shirt. So let me just go and try it on so you can see how it fits. And while I am trying on the dress, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button if you are loving this episode so far. Okay, so here it is. And as you can see, it has great structure. The V-neck is not too low at all. See, I can bend over and nothing is showing. You guys, I love this dress. And then these are not separate sleeves. You just cut, you know, one continuous piece of fabric, but it's got great coverage and it's super comfortable and I just love it. So some questions that you know are generally asked is, did I make any alterations to it? And I didn't. I made view D. And so you can see the length is pretty short. I cut the length that they showed, but then I added tiers at the bottom. So you can see that in that picture. So I added one length of ruffle to give it a little bit of length so that I could wear this to work. But this is probably one of my favorite makes because it is super fast to put together. So here are the line drawings, and it's got a few different options that you can do. You could even make a cute long sleeve shirt, or even you can make one of these for the fall. And I might even, I do have fabric that I wanna use for that one. So anyways, I am so excited with this pattern. This is like a new gem, 7742. You have to go out and get this pattern. And leave me a comment, let me know if you like it. If you enjoyed this pattern review, you're gonna love my other pattern review on the 7948. So thank you, I know this one was just short and sweet because the pattern is just short and sweet. But I wanna thank you for watching, and until next time, happy sewing. Bye guys.